Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will use the attach and detach feature to pick, move, and place a box in the 3D environment. Let's jump right into it. We have here the station exactly as we left it in the last video. So we have our robot, gripper, our box, two reference frame, and our table. I will delete the attach and detach program we created to start from scratch here. Perfect. So my goal is to pick the box from here and bring it there. So what I could do is simply, first of all, activate the right reference frame would be a very good idea. So here I want to work on the position A reference frame here. So I activated this one. Then I could either just eyeball it by moving the robot around here and kind of figuring out a position for it. Or I could enter the real position I want here, because I know here it's 100 by 100, so it would be like 50 by 50 here, X and Y, and then a certain height. Or I can use another trick if I want. I'm just gonna hide here the reference frame below here. And if I show here, right click and visible object reference, remember that this is the origin of your of the object you imported. If you right click this object, you can select get with robot. And you select the robot you want. If you have only one robot, you have only one solution. And what will happen is that the TCP or active TCP of the robot will come here and simply match with the origin of that part. So in this case, that's kind of useful. The only thing I need to do afterwards, so I have 50 and 50, which will be my X and Y position with respect to position here, reference frame. And I can maybe just move that up to 90, that makes sense. This gripper here is a bit too tight, but we will discuss how to make it an animated gripper that actually opens and closes later in a future tutorial. So for now, we'll stick with just a static one. Okay, now that we have a first position, I will create my, I'm gonna bring back this, remove the object reference frame here. I will create a first target that I will call pick A here. So this is pick position A. And I will double click the robot again and move, I don't know, to 200. And this will be my app A. Cool. Perfect. Now I simply need to create a pick program to go and pick that object here. So I can create a new program and let's call it pick A. And pick A will start by simply moving to the approach A. So select both of those using control and then add a joint motion. Then we will move linearly to go and grab the box. So I'm going to select pick A with a linear motion. So if I run this one here, no matter where the robot is, I will move to that first position and then move downward. Perfect. Starting from there, I need to attach the object. So I can either select here and then attach object, select the right gripper and leave the rest as is for now. We'll discuss that later. It will add me a attach to gripper and then the name of the gripper so I can verify that I have the right one. Then I need to move back up again one shot. So if I do that, I just need to move back to the approach position using a linear motion. So if I bring the robot somewhere, I can run pick A, move up, moves up, moves down, pick the box, moves back up. So now the box is part of my reference frame box. So I can't just move it here to position one. It won't necessarily position A. I can move it back here. It won't match with where it was before. I need to reuse my notepad for now. Like I said, next video, I'm going to show you a way to kind of record object in your station. Then I'm going to paste that here so that now I know I'm at the right spot. Perfect. Okay, so pick A works. Now I need to go the other way here with an approach motion and then go down and drop it here. So as those positions will be pretty much the same relative to the reference frame used. So pick A and app A relative to position A will be pretty much the same as pick B and app B with respective position B. So what I can do is simply copy those two here's here, and then rename them B and then B. Perfect. So now I have my app B and pick or drop B. So I can create my new program to drop it onto B. So create a new program. Let's call it place B. And then place B will be to go to app B as a joint motion. Go down as a linear motion to pick B. And then from pick B, I need to do a detach. I'm gonna add a simulation event. I'm gonna select under action detach object. Make sure that I have the right tool, which is the case as I only have one in this case. And I'll use the right reference frame to drop the object on. In this case, position B. And I'll click OK. And this will add the new, it will add the new instruction. Starting from here, I need to go back up to the approach pick approach B. So just like that, perfect. So now if I run this one and the object is dropped and it's now part of position B. So that's perfect. So if I simply move that object back here, as the relative position here was the same in both frame, I do not have to reposition it, and I can simply run pick A and then run place B, and the object is just positioned same exact position but in the other frame. I can now do the same to bring it back. So I can this time I'll just copy and paste those two programs. I will rename them pick B and then place A. So remember control C, control V. And now I simply need to switch the information in those. So here this will be position B. And then I will go for app B. I will go for pick B. I will go for app B. Perfect. So this will be pick B. If I run it, double click. Now I'm picking the object from B. And then I need to change again the reference frame and then the positions for the other one. Sometimes it's faster to just redo it from scratch, but in a case like this one, I believe that you have something to gain by simply using the copy and paste. The only thing that you also need to change here is the detach. Why? It would still detach the object properly. You wouldn't see much difference in the simulation, but you wouldn't be dropping the object in the right reference frame here. As you can see, we have position B and we would like to drop it in the position A reference frame here. So I'll go and select position A, click OK. So now if I go place A, I can drop it like that. If you remember correctly from now, you can select the programs in the order you want them to be executed using control hold and hold, or just shift and hold, right click, and then you can select make main program. It will make a main pick program. You can rename it main pick, let's say, and then you can run this one like that from one spot to the other. Perfect. And now you can right click and loop this program out so that it simply picks the object and move it from one side to the other. Okay, that's pretty much everything for this video. In the next one, as I promised you, I will show you a way to record the object position in your station so that you can easily kind of create a reset to any of your pick and place simulation, and you don't have to move the object around manually every single time you want to run a new run your program once again. Okay, hope it helps and have a great day, guys.